All right, here's the deal. Speaking of air quality, it has been difficult for some Clevelanders to breathe easy this summer.
Not only is the summer heat very uncomfortable, the wildfires from Canada are impacting our region's air quality, and that could put a strain, believe it or not, on your heart. Filling in for Dr. Mark today is our friend Dr. Steve Nissen from the Cleveland Clinic. And first of all, thank you so much for stopping by today. And I'm never, you know, when you breathe in this air and the smoke, and you think it's uncomfortable. But what you're saying is we could see long-term effects.
I think there's very great concerns, not just because of the exposure now, but, you know, this is the new normal. You know, with global warming, there are going to be more fires and more smoke. Now, it's particularly bad this year. But there's lots of scientific evidence that it is damaging to the lungs, that smoke, but it also has a relationship to development of heart disease. These things are just so tiny, these particulate matter from the smoke. They get deep into the lungs, they get absorbed into the body. There are really serious concerns. And of course, we also have the heat problem that people have to deal with. So we're really in a very difficult time right now.
Yeah. I know people tend to think the elderly are most affected by something like this. Would you say that adults, children, though, might even be in a category of concern?
Well, I'm worried about children for sure. Because remember that if you do something that causes cancer, cancer doesn't happen right away. It happens decades later. And so I worry about whether we're going to have a spike in lung cancer, you know, down the road, 20 years from now. Yeah. And keep in mind that children are going to get exposed over and over again because of all of the developments now with global warming and with increased fires.
Doctor, I can see the relation between what we're taking in, what we're breathing in, lung disease, but you just mentioned heart disease?
Yes. There have been scientific studies that have shown, for example, that people that live in cities where they're exposed to diesel exhaust and other forms of smoke, there is an increase in heart disease, and this is no different. And so we have concerns about both lung and heart disease related to the air quality.
So I think then when people are listening to all of this, they're thinking, what can I do? What can I control in this situation? And something that's interesting would be making sure that we are being proactive and looking at what the air quality is like before we spend any time outdoors.
Well, I look at it every day. You know, there are apps that you can get on your phone that will show you the air quality. Happens to be 31 is the number for today. Under 100 is considered acceptable. If it's 100 to 200, it's unhealthy. And over 200, you really don't want to spend much time.
But if you don't have that app, how can you tell? You can't tell, can you?
Well, I think it's going to be important now for the media to maybe begin to inform people almost on a daily basis about air quality concerns, because, you know, you are the people that can communicate this information very widely.
A lot of people don't take it serious. You know, they hear it, you know, and they just keep on with their daily lives, but that could be a problem.
Well, there are things you can do. You can exercise indoors. You know, I happen to have an exercycle in my home, and I have a very well-filtered, you know, home, so the environment is certainly better indoors than it is outdoors. Mm-hmm. But keep in mind also that the heat is a risk.
The heat,
and,
yeah.
You know, you shouldn't be out exercising in the heat of the day, say between noon and 3 p.m., you're going to get greater heat exposure. So I tell people, get out in the morning, do your exercise early before the heat becomes really severe.
Right. Yeah, for sure.
I could ask you about 500 more questions. Unfortunately, we have to go. But thank you so much again, Dr. Nissen, for coming in. And I think if we take anything from this, get onto those apps, find out what the air quality is, make sure you're taking care of your body in the only way that you can ahead of potential problems down the road.
And stay out of the heat.
Stay, and that's key, especially if you're down south right now. My goodness gracious, this is a mess down there.
Hot.
All right, doctor, thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
My pleasure.